Those who are unintelligent are without understanding. They are stupid and ungodly, because a wicked man has no mind for the things which make for salvation. The intelligent have understanding. They are wise, learned, and prudent. Consider and put together perception, your ability to see, hear, and become aware, your insight, consciousness, and understanding with the thing perceived, that you may achieve understanding, that you may see. Believe in the possibility and understand the true character and nature of God, that He may receive you as a guest, so that you may accompany Him. Set it in your mind to understand and be wise. The man of understanding is a good and upright man, having the knowledge of those things which pertain to salvation. Be wise, and you shall be in fellowship, action, and belief, to experience a state and condition of a fellowship far closer and more intimate than what can be expressed. You shall be with Christ to accompany Him on a journey, as a companion, as His fellow craftsman, as an artisan, a master, and skilled workman, just as the Creator, standing beside Him to be associated with Him, to arrive as an apostle, having the influential position and power as a result, to be furnished and equipped, carrying your gift or bounty, procuring benefit. You shall be equipped with the power and virtues of our Lord Jesus Christ, to live with Christ, united in spiritual bonds to Him, and to lead a strong life by virtue of this union. Besides all this, you shall be united all in one completely in the mind of Christ, assimilated and absorbed in a state of mental concentration into the customs, attitudes, and knowledge of the Alpha and Omega. He shall appear, and His appearance shall be in brightness, a glorious manifestation of God in His advent to help you. This is the signal deed, sign, token, mark, and event betokening the presence and power of God as your helper. This is the advent of Christ, by which His presence and power appear in the saving light He has shed upon all mankind, but is now made manifest by the appearing of our Savior, Jesus Christ, who hath abolished death and hath brought life and immortality to light through the gospel. This is the illustrious return from heaven to earth, hereafter to occur, breaking forth, being conspicuous, notable, and terrible. The sun shall be turned into darkness, and the moon into blood, before the great and terrible day of the Lord. He shall appear and become clearly known, for His anger endureth but a moment. In His favor is life. Weeping may endure for a night, but joy cometh in the morning. Let me not be ashamed, O Yahweh, for I have called upon Thee. Let the wicked be ashamed, and let them be silent in the grave. He shall shine bright and resplendent when He is exposed to view. We shall see the appearance of angels, Yah, and those restored to life. Never was it seen in such so remarkable a fashion. Never was such a sight seen in Israel? And if the righteous scarcely be saved, where shall the ungodly and the sinner appear? He will nowhere be seen. He will perish. Yehoshua declares, "What think ye of the light of God, which shall be exposed to the view of all? Do you have the power of understanding? Make known your thoughts, announce and acknowledge Yahweh. Express your support that He is the true light that shines bright and resplendent, because He is the light that shall be seen. Yahweh is light because light has the extremely delicate, subtle, pure, and brilliant quality of truth and its knowledge, together with spiritual purity, and His light shall be exposed to the view of all. Reason with others. Explain the underlying fact that provides logical sense for this occurrence, that they may have the capacity for logical, rational, and analytical thought and intelligence when He shines forth. Yahweh's light shall be upon you, and an obligation, a vow, shall be laid upon you, appropriating to yourselves the name of Messiah, and you shall rely upon that name and authority. The two witnesses shall testify and take hostile aim against the adversary in me, showing enmity against him and being antagonistic to the enemy in warfare. Yehoshua declares, "You shall be transferred, undergoing a change, and be moved from one place to another when I blow upon you. This is your intended arrival, that benefit may accrue to you. You shall name the name of Jesus, that help may come from that name. And you shall be assembled and brought together in the same place to convene for your official and public purpose upon arrival into the vicinity of that place, near judges and kings, to their tribunals, standing on the right hand of God against the enemy, pointing him out to defeat the thief and robber, bringing evils upon him." Yehoshua declares, "Blessings shall come upon you, and you shall be in a trance. The Holy Spirit shall rest upon you to put a covenant upon you. I shall call you to put a name upon you, the number and degree you have reached. This is the end to which your mind has been led unto God, to be entrusted in His care at the direction of His will, action of purpose and end, to receive His baptism, to be in hostility against the adversary. On the morrow, my influence shall rest upon you, and this condition and obligation shall be imposed upon you. It is an accumulation of increase, that you may be made grateful, raised to a higher position in the hierarchy, in degree and rank, as a defense and safeguard, to be in hostile opposition and resistance to the adversary, directed and commanded by Yahweh. You shall stand out in prominence as a peak or summit of a mountain, swelling in eminence, excellence, and superiority as the prominent men of the city. You shall hold and possess in your hand property and riches, and you shall be joined to Christ by the bonds of natural blood and marriage, that you may adhere and cling to Him when you exit out of the body and out of the world. You shall be a mental pariah, intellectual, rational, theoretical, cerebral, and free from mental defects, appealing to the use of intellect rather than emotion, endowed with the capacity of reason, capable of logical thought and of a sound mind, with a high degree of intellect, of abstract concepts which are hard to understand. You shall be a teacher, professor, and master, as Jesus, highly skilled and proficient, pure, free from defilement or pollution, as a chaste virgin without sin, having no faults, being ritually clean, clear, and true. You shall be a social outcast and untouchable, a homeless vagabond and wanderer, an outlaw who is untouchable, beyond the reach of criticism, impeachment, or attack, above reproach, out of the reach of others, immune to attack and impregnable, incapable of being transgressed or dishonored, considered persona non grata, unaccepted by the government, a troublemaker and villain, a scoundrel and wretch. But you are a diplomat, appointed to represent the government of Yahweh, an emissary and minister, one who is authorized to perform religious functions, carrying out specific orders from Yahweh, as his servant, as his divine man of the cloth, supremely beautiful and magnificent, having the nature of a deity, angelic, superhuman, and godlike, devoted to Yahweh, to declare prophecy, as a witness, to give testimony under divine inspiration. This shall become clear, manifest, and evident in the miracle from the sky. Amen. Shalom.